the times I start a sewing project, I'm using a PDF pattern. This is different than the patterns you would get at a fabric store like Joann Fabrics that come in a packet. This is something digitally that you print off at home. When you print it off, you have to tape it together and cut it out, and it'll wind up looking like this. The benefits of having a PDF pattern is that if you have access to a vector editing software like Adobe Illustrator or something similar, you have the opportunity to modify those pattern pieces before you print them out. For me personally, my bust size, waist size, and hip size are very different. I'm a very pear-shaped person, and one of the benefits of sewing is that I can ensure that my garments fit that size and that I don't have to fit into my clothing. My clothing can fit me. So a way I do this is by modifying my patterns and just sloping between the sizes. I have been asked several times to make a longer form video about how I do this, so if you're one of those people who are interested in how to use Adobe Illustrator to make your sewing patterns fit a little bit better and print a little bit better and conserve paper when you're printing, this is the video for you. Enjoy!
So the first thing is going to be to take this PDF and make it into images that we can plop into Illustrator. This is very easy, just menu, export a PDF, image, and then I do a JPEG, but it really doesn't matter. Make sure you know where that's going to go. I put it into this folder. So going back to my PDF for a second, you can see that at the top here, this shows how this is going to print. It's a 6x5 grid. Actually, this is 6x6, but whatever. So we're gonna go over here into Illustrator. We're gonna go File, New. I'm in the US and my printer prints on letter size paper, so I'm gonna choose letter that's 8.5x11. We're gonna do 30 artboards. You can always add more or delete these, it doesn't matter. And then we're gonna go to More Settings. Here I'm gonna go 6 columns. This is important because that's how my PDF is set up, with 6 columns across. 30 artboards, yes, and this is super important right here. You want 0 spacing. And just make sure everything still looks right, still letter, whatever. Create document, perfect. So you can see that this grid looks like this, right? Perfect. So going back into Illustrator, now we're going to drag all of these into Illustrator. And now this is really tedious, but we're gonna have to start arranging them. And honestly, these dump in different ways. Like, I swear almost every time I do one of these, but you just kind of want to lay them in there. It doesn't matter right now how they're gonna look, because after you get them all in the right place, you're gonna go back through and make sure they all line up super nicely. That is gonna look like this. So ignoring where the actual page breaks are, which are these lines right here, these are the pattern pieces. So I set them to overlap perfectly so that the pattern pieces are whole and they're not stretched out. There's no gaps in between them. In order to do this really easily, I set the opacity to multiply, and then I also set them to 30%. You don't have to do that right now, but it's going to come in handy when later you trace out these pattern pieces, because they're just going to be a lower opacity than your pen tool. So first step is to make sure that these are all together. This is what the pattern pieces look like ultimately, and you can see your whole pattern is really here super clearly. The other PDF I have in here as well, I did the same thing. You can see that I can just sort of turn it on and off. This is obviously the skirt pieces, and this is like the top pieces. There's also some skirt pieces in here, but you can see that this is part one of the PDF pattern, and this is part two. So also over here, you can see that I have the bigger size. I said earlier that I have 2 sizes on this, and that's because my bust size is different than like my hip size according to this pattern. I have these all grouped together, and this looks super chaotic, I know, but pattern piece by pattern piece, I will line these up. Most pattern pieces have like spots that like align when you're grading them. I can align this notch, perfect. So this now goes from size 8 all the way up to, I believe that's 28. So for this pattern, my bust is kind of in between sizes 14 and 16. My waist puts me firmly at the pattern size 18, and my hips are somewhere between 22 and size 22 and 20. Obviously, if I made this pattern for my largest size, 22, it's going to be falling off of my bust. And if I made it to match my waist, it wouldn't hit my hips. It would be super tight on my hips, and it would be falling off my bust still. And if I made it 14, it wouldn't fit anywhere else. So I am making my own garment, so I would like my garment to fit me perfectly. So in order to do this, I'm going to have to kind of blend these sizes together. This bodice upper front, that's only on the bust, so I would just trace that to my size. I'm gonna move on to this bodice. What is it actually? It's hard to see. Bodice lower front. And again, there's a couple lines where this like lines up regardless of size, so we're gonna wanna line it up there. And I'm gonna open a different layer.
Using the pen tool, I'm gonna very carefully trace along these pattern pieces. Remembering that at the top where my bust is, I'm a size 14. At the bottom where my waist is, I want to be a size 18. So I'm going to slowly and very carefully trace this pattern piece out following those size lines. I'm using a cyan line just because it stands out a little bit better against the black of the pattern piece. And I'm going to switch this to be a 2-point line, so it's not super thick, but it definitely stands out. And I'm going to just slowly work those curves to trace this pattern piece. You want to make sure that you blend these pieces as nicely as possible so it doesn't throw off the other pattern pieces. You're going to want to match the notches as closely as you can. You can see the place where the notch would be, the line is in a slightly different location, and that's fine. You just kind of want to estimate. And then when you print it out, you're going to take those notches with a little bit of a grain of salt. They might not line up super perfectly, but they'll line up pretty closely, especially if you're following the same ethos with where you put those notches every time you blend these pieces together.
Okay, so that looks about like the pattern piece blended pretty nicely between the 18 and the 14. We can kind of just move on to all the other ones, and you're going to wind up with something that looks like this. I changed all the lines back to black.
I labeled them. The next most important thing is you can probably tell that these pattern pieces aren't where they were on the pattern, and that's because I know that my printer is going to print with about a 1/4 inch blank space all around each page. Different printers print differently, but I know that mine needs about a 1/4 inch around there, around each page, it's going to be just blank. So I want to make sure I drag these pieces around to where that blank piece isn't going to be on a corner or a notch or anything like that. So I just move these around so that the places that are going to be blank, the like blank gaps, aren't going to be important.
If something like this line falls in between that border, that's not really going to matter because I can just kind of keep on tracing the line as it goes. If you're kind of unsure, I always just make a rectangle 8.5 by 11, and then I make sure that stroke is aligned that way. And then I will just kind of drag this around
if there's anywhere I'm unsure about.
This is inside this blue box is now my safe area. So I'll just drag it around and make sure everything's within that safe area. We could print like this, but I like to put numbers on there. These are all just different text box. It doesn't take very long to do this. What you see here is more or less what you're going to get for the real thing. And so that means you're not going to have to trim the edges of a bunch of things. I have found that this saves me a ton of paper. It also saves me quite a bit of time.
And what's really important to me is I have these all in a digital archive. So if anything happens to my paper patterns, if I spill a cup of coffee on it, or if over the course of cutting out multiple layers of fabric, they just get a little bit dinged up, I can reprint them, and I know that whatever alterations I made to make these fit me, these are going to fit the same way, rather than printing it out and then trying to make the alterations before you do the first cut. These are all saved digitally.
I hope this was helpful, and I hope that you're going to be able to use this in your sewing projects.
Please like and subscribe if this was helpful for you. And if there's any parts of this that you would like a little bit more detail on, please leave a comment below. I would be happy to clarify. This is a process I use almost every time I start a new sewing project, but I understand that it's not a super typical sewing process. So if you have any questions at all, please let me know and I'll be happy to answer them to the best of my ability. Happy sewing!